It is like water and ice. Apart from water, no ice. Water is everywhere in our life and stories. Its power to transform, its sensitivity to surroundings. Whether it is still or cascading in torrents down the Himalayas, or changing into solid ice, or the vapor of cloud. A source of health, or deadly disease. It is a mysterious substance. Other pictures and symbolism of water pervade our mental life too. For instance, the sea as a symbol of the unconscious mind, as the abode of the great whales of history and literature. In the secular, biblical, Buddhist and Upanishadic accounts of life. In this collection of stories, a clue lies in the title. A lake may be turbulent, a pool may be agitated, but their natural mode is stillness. It is in calmness that we are best able to act and to be. Basic to yoga and Zen training is stillness. Further training builds on this so that stillness can be retained even in vigorous movement. In his personal way of speaking, the warmest praise that Trevor Leggett gave was to those he described as having kept the child inside alive. This wasn't some doctrine, but the spontaneous talk of a man who himself was so alive that to be in his presence was energizing. Knowing him as a great figure of so many achievements in languages, as a transmitter of Japanese culture, an expert practitioner in meditation based on the Upanishads and the Bhagavad Gita, and Zen monastic meditation, a successful writer, a high grade in Japanese chess, it was a delight to find that indeed, the child in him was so alive, he liked to play.